take your mind back. I don't know when, sometime when it always seemed to be just us and them. Girls that wore pink, boys that wore blue, boys that always grew up better men than me. What's a man now? What's a man mean? Is he rough or is he rugged? Is he cultural and clean? Now it's all changed. It's got to change more, 'cause we think it's getting better, but nobody's really sure. And so it goes, go round again. But now and then we wonder who the real men are. Between the sexes, and there'll be no people left. And so it goes, go round again. But now and then we wonder who the real men are. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to this online service here this day at Sunshine Salvos. Welcome to spring and a new season, this first day of September 2024. A new season, a season of life, a season of green, of hope, of warmth, and a season where we have every good reason to feel optimistic and good about life, because all of the goodness of God's creation comes out in its finest in the season of spring. And we know that everything that God made was exceedingly good. And so are you. And I'm glad that you've joined us here on this day, this special day here in Australia. Of course, on the first Sunday of September, we celebrate Father's Day. And so I would say, to all fathers who are watching out there, happy Father's Day to you. Of course, I do also want to add to that that at Sunshine Salvos, it is our position on days such as Father's Day and Mother's Day that we don't just contain our focus to fathers and mothers, but this day dictates that we at Sunshine Salvos want to honour all men. The men who have been important to us in our lives, those special men of influence, of comfort and strength, the men who have been important to us in our lives. And so that's who we think about and honour today. And of course, for such a day, you would appreciate that we will be looking at a theme of manhood. I've entitled the service today, "Where Have All the Real Men Gone?" because that was a question that was posed to me recently, and it's a little bit of a growing thought among some, particularly in the conservative Christian church, about what is real manliness. Where have all the real men gone? We're going to have a look at that question and see if we can find them. Or perhaps we might even find that they've been around us all the time. But we'll get to that, of course, in just a little while. It's been a big week for the Salvation Army here in Australia this week. We have had the international leader of the Salvation Army, General Lyndon Buckingham, and his wife, Commissioner Bronwyn Buckingham, doing a tour of Australia, which culminates this very day in Melbourne, where a little later this afternoon, there will be a large public rally where people, Salvos from all across Victoria, will be coming particularly to be inspired by the international leader, General Buckingham, and his words, and also Commissioner Bronwyn as well, to be ministered to by our world leaders. It's going to be a really exciting afternoon. So it's a special day in the life of the Salvation Army in Australia today. I was looking around for some different acknowledgements of country. You know, we are indebted to the work of the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander team here within the Salvos in Australia. And I regularly use two acknowledgement of country videos, one featuring Tahana Turner and the other featuring Auntie Sue Hodges. I just felt that it would be good if we had something different. So today, I'm indebted to Julie Thompson for this beautiful acknowledgement of country video which she put together that really does emphasize the wisdom, the gratitude, and the great debt we have in our learning and looking to the contribution of First Nations people to Australia in 2024. So thank you, Julie Thompson, for putting this video together, and we are going to enjoy it now as we commence this worship time in acknowledging the traditional custodians of the land where we're gathered this day.
We are honoured to be gathered to acknowledge country.
Dance on country. Sing on country. Visit country. We speak to country. Care for country. Long for country.
We pay our respects to elders, past and present, and thank them for passing on their knowledge. Our language and spiritual connection to country. Country is lived on and lived with. Country gives and receives life.
To that, the commitment of the Salvation Army that is ongoing to the process of reconciliation, walking alongside First Nations people to achieve justice for them and to provide a voice for them wherever and whenever necessary. A Father's Day prayer, a prayer of thanksgiving and gratitude that acknowledges not only fathers but the important men in our lives. Would you join with me this day as we commence this worship time in prayer? Lord, this day, Father, we give thanks for the men who have held us close when we needed strength and love. For the dads and the men who have guided us and given us a solid set of values to live by. We thank you for those men who, in providing their example, their wisdom, and their advice, would then also set us free to find out for ourselves just who we want to be and who we are. We thank you for those men. We thank you, Lord, for the dads and for the important men in our lives who dreamt great dreams for us. And yet they were also the ones we are so thankful for who accepted the dreams that we decided we would pursue. We thank you for the men who were vulnerable, who were loving and forgiving, who were gentle, the ones who would always show their love for us unconditionally and loved and accepted us just the way we are. We thank you for those fathers and those important men who exemplified the father-like qualities of you, Lord. We thank you for them this day. We pray this in the name of God, the Father. Amen. I have a new cup that I got just in the past week or so. You may look at it and think that's not a very manly, masculine cup. I actually really like it. It's good enough for me. We're going to worship in song this day. We're going to sing together, "Holy, holy, holy, Lord God Almighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity." This ancient hymn, this wonderful anthem of the church, would you join with me this day as we sing together, "Holy, holy, holy"?
The
and we move into a time of prayer for this new month. Prayer concerns of this world, of our nation, of our communities, and praying for special people at Sunshine Salvos, our dear friends who need our prayers in these days. Would you join with me as together we pray? Amen. Some announcements I have for today. And they are all here in the newsletter, which has been uploaded, is on the Sunshine Salvos Facebook group page. You can see it there and consult this newsletter for the month of September. It has all the information you need for what's going on at Sunshine Salvos in a busy month. Of course, as I mentioned just earlier, today is a significant day in the Salvation Army here in Australia. Here in Melbourne, we will have the General of the Salvation Army, General Lyndon Buckingham, and his wife, Commissioner Bronwyn Buckingham, leading us in a public rally this afternoon from 4 o'clock till 6 o'clock at the Melbourne Convention and Exhibition Centre. That is going to be a large gathering of salvos from around Melbourne and Greater Victoria that will certainly be an uplifting occasion, and I would encourage you, if you can get along to it, you certainly would want to be there to enjoy that. And that it will be the final engagement of the General and Commissioner Bronwyn Buckingham on their Australian tour. Other announcements for this coming month include, blokes, we're going fishing. And that is happening next Saturday, the 7th of September, from 12 p.m. midday through to 3 p.m. in the afternoon at Werribee South Jetty. It's an afternoon of fishing. And as I often say, fishing doesn't necessarily mean or imply that it is essential to catch fish. If you catch fish, well, that's a bonus. But the real purpose and art of fishing is just doing the fishing. And even better when you're together with friends to talk, to catch up, and to be still in nature. Fishing for you blokes this Saturday. Come along, let me know if you're going to be there. I really look forward to casting a line with you. Ladies, we're not leaving you out this month. Of course, the following Saturday, the 14th of September, there will be a shine outing for the ladies of Sunshine. You're heading down the highway, going to Geelong for a lovely cafe lunch, and then enjoying a coffee. And I'm pretty sure there'll be some sweets, some cakes, and lovely things as well at Major Alison Platt's house. That's for you ladies this Saturday week, the 14th of September. There will be transport provided. A bus will be leaving Sunshine Salvos at 10 a.m. on that Saturday morning, the 14th of September. Get along to that ladies, it's going to be a great afternoon. Other announcements include Father's Day things that of course are happening today at Sunshine Salvos a little later in our gathered worship. We are continuing certainly with our service to the community in the area of emergency food relief. Our community meal program continues to be very heavily used because of the demand of people needing some extra help for food in our communities. That's where you can also give us a hand in providing for us, if you are in a position to do it, some non-perishable goods. Things like long life milk, pastas, rice, pasta sauce, biscuits, instant noodles, coffee, tea. Those kinds of items that would normally take their place in your shelf, in your kitchen pantry. We desperately are needing more and more of those items to try and keep up with the demand of people from our community needing extra help. We want to be able to serve our local community the best way we can through food hampers and through our community meal program. Please help out with that if you can. Please help out with that if you're in a position to do so. As I said, the Spring September newsletter is there on our Sunshine Salvos Facebook page for you to consult. In our prayers for this week, the September prayer list reminds us to lift up before the Lord in prayer Yasmin, Doran, and her two beautiful children, Ollie and Scarlett. Please pray for them this week. Consult the newsletter. Everything's in there for what's going on at Sunshine in September. We'll leave those announcements there for today. It would make sense, wouldn't it, that if we wanted to find the best example possible of who a real man was, then we may well look to Jesus. This particular lovely worship song simply reminds us of that wonderful truth and important practice that we all must remember to do, to turn our eyes upon Jesus, to look full into his wonderful face. And when we do that, the things of earth, the things and the issues around us in our life, they grow dim. They're put into a right perspective in the light of his glory and his grace. We're going to turn our eyes upon Jesus this morning as we sing in worship of him. Bible verse, and I mean that, just one verse this morning. We've had some lengthy Bible readings recently. I thought it was time we just stuck to one verse and made things a bit simple. And this particular Bible verse, a well-known one, comes from the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 16, verse 7. 1 Samuel, chapter 16, verse 7. This verse finds its place within the context of the seeking and searching for a new king of the new nation of Israel. That search came to the house of Jesse among the many sons that he had. And we find this verse in that context. But the Lord said to Samuel, "Do not look on his appearance or on the height of his stature, because I have rejected him. For the Lord sees not as man sees. Man looks on the outward appearance, but the Lord looks on the heart." May God add wisdom to the reading of that word this day. As I mentioned at the outset of the service this morning, a very well-meaning colleague of mine, a man who I respect and admire greatly, a man who has grown up within the conservative Church of England faith and tradition, asked me a question recently at a board meeting of the Salvation Army. And the question was this: where have all the real men gone? And it was a question that I thought about for a moment, probably more thinking about where that question came from and what really was the things going on beneath that question. And I came to a conclusion that I don't think that the real men have gone anywhere. I think that real men have always been around us in many different shapes and forms. But I think what really underpinned that question of where have all the real men gone was a particular view that held to a masculinized picture or understanding of what a real man was or is. And I think these days we often do hear about the way or the complaints of men at times in the community, feeling as though they're under pressure to be perhaps more balanced, more feminine, more politically correct. Men feeling as though they're under siege, that their masculinity is being called into question, that they don't feel as though they are at liberty to enjoy the kinds of freedoms that they once had in their very manly, masculine way, perhaps through their words and their actions, that they don't feel that they have those freedoms anymore because the world has changed and their masculinity or the definition of what it means to be a real man is changing. At the beginning of this service, there was a fantastic song. It's one of my favorite songs from back in the 1980s by Joe Jackson. It was probably, well, certainly his most famous song. It was a little of a one-hit wonder, you might say. But this particular song, Real Men, is a powerful song. For the purpose of transparency, I want to clearly say that the song itself was written really from the perspective of speaking into the issues of gay men, particularly in and around that time when certainly HIV/AIDS was a very big issue in our communities at that time, and gay men felt very threatened and quite alienated at that time. This song came out questioning who are the real men. And it's a beautiful song. I use it this morning, transparently giving you the context for what it was written out of, but it holds many good thoughts to this topic appropriately that we look at today on Father's Day, of where have all the real men gone? Have they really gone anywhere? Or do we really need to reevaluate again our own understandings and our own interpretations of who we think and what we define a real man as being? I remember, and this memory came up for me recently, when I was in Vietnam, I went to a family lunch. It was a lunch put on by cousins of Captain Fung in the very large city of Da Nang in central Vietnam, and went there and enjoyed a great lunch. But in the midst of that lunch, one relative, who I don't see often, but I certainly know him, came to me during the proceedings with a bottle of beer. And he said to me, "Ah, Colin, here is your beer." And I said, "Well, actually, no, I don't drink alcohol. Just get me a Coke or a bottle of water. That will be fine." And he looked at me with a look that said to me that he was genuinely perplexed that I would not take that bottle of beer from him and drink it, perhaps in his mind thinking that that's what real men do. That perhaps he had this underlying attitude and belief that real masculinity is somehow contained within a beer bottle or some other bottle of alcohol. He was somewhat thrown by the fact that I refused his offer. Maybe in his mind he felt like I had really emasculated myself. I don't know, but that's who I am, and I'm comfortable, of course, in who I am. That kind of incident's actually happened to me quite a number of times within the context of Vietnamese culture, where it's a very traditional kind of view of masculinity within Vietnamese culture that men sit down in the afternoon with other men, sit around, maybe drink coffee, often drink beer or rice wine, smoking cigarettes, and that's the mark of a real man. I think that we can assume correctly that there are some real issues with that kind of definition of manliness. And so I think to myself, well, what kind of man am I? I guess I'm someone who looks to the people around me who have been significant men in and around my life, the influences on me, the ones who have shaped me and formed me into the kind of person I am today, that in my own way reflects my own sense of masculinity and manhood. And so, if I think about the most important and influential man in my life who has shaped and formed who I am today in my character, in my values, then I really look no further than at this man, this particular painting of my dad. Major Keith Reynolds was painted by his grandson, Luke. And we certainly have this painting in pride of place within our home. I want to share with you some things about my dad and why I believe in every way, shape and form, he is a real man. And in the context of that question, he hasn't gone anywhere. He was always there. He was certainly there for me. And he's a big part of who I am today. This is my dad. My dad loves China painting. My dad loves knitting. He loves cross stitching. He loves fixing clothes. Even at times he had done crochet. My dad doesn't really have much of an athletic bone in his body. And he doesn't much like sports, though he does enjoy watching test cricket and occasionally some football as well, and the tennis. But as for getting out and doing some of those things, well, I don't think that's ever been something my dad has ever been much interested in. My dad loves gardening. My dad loves making his home lovely and nice. And many people, many men, maybe with ideas of masculinity that are a bit toxic, many of them might look at my dad and say, he's not really a real man. He's a bit of a soft man. He's a bit of a Nancy boy, perhaps. But I want to say that he is the realest man that I know, and I love him because he is exactly who he is. You can see here, I have a cap that's sitting there. That cap belonged to my grandfather, my dad's dad. And you might think, well, if my father exemplifies all of those qualities that I went through, all of those things that he loves to do, knitting, crocheting, cross-stitching, what was his dad like? Did he pass those things down to my dad? This cap belonged to my grandfather, my pop. And I can tell you that my pop really, in many ways, was certainly not like my dad. He didn't knit, not to the best of my knowledge. He didn't paint. He didn't do cross stitch. He didn't crochet. He did love gardening. My pop was a welder. He taught welding at RMIT, the Royal Melbourne Institute of Technology, right in the heart of Melbourne. And my pop, I remember as a young kid looking at him, had forearms that were like branches of a tree. He was a strong man, a physically strong man. He loved manual things like welding, like looking at cars and doing things very labor intensive. That was who my pop was, and yet he also was a real man. The thing that I think he handed down to my dad was a love of gardening. So men are different, aren't they? The real men and who they are around our lives don't really fit one mold. Not as this world or some people would like you to believe. You know, there's people, particularly toxic men out there, who really do believe that real men are the ones who look down the barrel of a gun when they're hunting some poor animal and they kill it just for the sake of their own thrill. There are real, real toxic men out there who believe that real masculinity is contained within a bottle of alcohol. There are men out there, toxic in their masculinity, who believe it's their God-given right to acknowledge the beauty of a woman walking past them and give them a wolf whistle or let them know that, geez, you're beautiful, love. Those men still exist and they think that's their right to be manly in that way. There are real toxic men out there who believe that when a wife doesn't do what the man says they should do, then it's quite okay to physically remind them of who's the boss in the house. And let it not be forgotten, here in this country, this developed, blessed, so-called lucky country of Australia, do not forget the fact that every single week in this nation, one woman is murdered by an act of family and domestic violence by men. Because there still exists this attitude that it's quite okay to rough up a woman and that that's really your right as a real man. I come against that absolutely, wholeheartedly, and call it for what it is, an abhorrent, toxic expression of not just masculinity, but personhood. There is no place for that. Part of the song we listened to at the start, there's a lyric in that song that says that things are changing, but they have to change more. Can I say, in our nation of Australia, this attitude that it is okay to be violent towards women is something that has to change. There's no justification, there's no place within masculinity in any way that gives justification for violence against women. So what is a real man? Where have they all gone? I want to say this morning they never left. They've been around us. They've been expressing themselves in different ways. And it's not just the heteronormative view of masculinity, but we accept now within our society that those who are same-sex attracted or however they want to identify in life in our community also add to the rich fabric of manliness and masculinity. Where are the real men? They're right where they are in your life. And I pray that this day you can give thanks to God for the real men, the ones who have been instrumental in being a part of your life in a positive way. Knowing, of course, that there may have been some men in your life that have been awful in their own way and very negative in their contribution to your life and who you are. But I pray that you can thank God this day for the really good ones, the real ones, the men who simply are their true selves, the men who love and care and support, the men who give us freedom to chart our own way, the men who are just beautiful men because they are gentlemen. May we thank God this day for the wonderful men, the fathers, the grandfathers, the uncles, the brothers, the cousins, all of those men in and around our lives who have been real men for us. This day is as good as any day, but really, every day should be a day of gratitude for those men and those women in and around our life who have blessed us and helped us to be who we really are. Let's pray. We thank you, God, because you have placed men in our lives. We hope and trust for good reasons, but knowing, Lord, that there have also been men in and around our lives who have not been good, and we are mindful of that on this day. We ask that you would give strength and comfort to those this day whose experiences of men within their life has been far from good. And yet, Lord, within that, we also want to express our gratitude for the good men, the real men in and around our life. Bless us this day as we remind them just how special they are to us. We pray these things in the name of God, our Father. Amen. A prayer of benediction I'll leave with you today. May the love of God, our Father, and the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the fellowship of the Spirit of God be with you this week as you go through this special day, if you are so able, to remind those special men in and around your life just how valuable and special and gentle they are. Amen. God bless you this week. Have a great week. It's exciting that next week we're going to be beginning a new series. This series, which I'm going to explain more about next week as we start it, asks a simple question. What if? What if this particular thing from the life of Jesus didn't happen the way that it did? It's going to be an interesting journey we take in looking at a number of key moments in and through the life of Jesus and his ministry, and we're going to turn them around and just have a look at what might have been. What if it didn't happen the way that we have been used to knowing from God's word those important things in the life of Jesus? That's next Sunday. I hope you will join me for the beginning of that series. I hope you can come into the city of Melbourne a little later today for the rally, enjoying and being inspired by the General of the Salvation Army. Have a great week. In any case, we will see you back here in this space next Sunday. Until then, God bless you. And dads out there, happy Father's Day. Oh,
question. What if?